the machine that you see here, will see here, is number 17. He still owns the prototype number 1. So you can see we've sold a few of these. This is called the Archeophone. It's called the Archeophone because Archeo being like archaeology, he sees this as being a machine that enables you to do the archaeology of the cylinder. This machine is the finest cylinder reproducing instrument that has ever been built. In fact, this particular machine is the finest that's ever been built. Because as he has built these machines over the years, or months, we've continued to modify things and tweak things and change them somewhat. So this is absolutely state of the art and was delivered to me about 3 weeks ago. What I want to do here is go through a number of cylinders to demonstrate the capabilities of this phonograph. Now, I want to make a couple of comments right off the bat. First of all, I'm going to say some things that are generalities. Whenever you're talking about old records, there are always exceptions to everything, and we understand that, just like with music boxes. But in general, what I'm going to be talking about will hold true for in most cases. What I'm going to talk about on these cylinders, we're going to go with different features of a cylinder. We'll start off talking about cylinder speed, and we're going to talk about the groove, and we're going to talk about the way the cylinder is constructed. And finally, we're going to talk about groove pitch. Now, if you have questions as we go, I'm happy to answer them, but bear in mind that you probably have a question that I'm eventually going to get to, so we'll see how that goes. What I'm going to do is start off with the earliest cylinder that I brought, which is, perhaps not the earliest, but it's an early cylinder. This is a brown wax recording. In the United States, this was the first type of widely available cylinder. Move the table back and I can't get to my numbers. The Archeophone uses a number of different mandrel sizes to accomplish its task. We won't use absolutely every one of these this afternoon, but we'll probably use most of them. All right, this is a standard size cylinder. Most all cylinders that you encounter are going to be generally this size. This is a 4-inch long cylinder and will fit on your typical Edison machines that you're familiar with. I'm going to fit to this machine a stylus which has an Edison Model C doorknob stylus cemented to the cantilever. I ground off the diamond stylus that was there and replaced it with this Edison stylus. The weakest link of this machine is, in fact, the stylus, because there's never been any real serious investigation into the proper types, sizes, and shapes of styli to reproduce cylinders, at least not since cylinders were being made a century ago. And so there is an effort underway right now by the Association for Recorded Sound Collections, of which Dr. Mike Conchalian over here, he's a member of that cylinder subcommittee. They are working on really trying to determine what the ideal, the optimal stylus would be to reproduce any given type of cylinder. But at this point, it's still very much a trial and error thing, and I'm going to be switching styli as we go, depending on what kind of cylinder we're playing. Let's see if we got sound coming through. This particular cylinder plays at 120 RPM, so we'll move that down.
Is that a typical speed, or?
It's a typical speed for early cylinders. Most cylinders that you encounter will be 160, which are later.
Over to William Penn. thank you, old man, for Columbia Phonograph Company of New York and Paris.
Cylinders, but just enough to kind of give you an idea. I've selected cylinders that were interesting musically, as well as show the features that I want to demonstrate. And I've tried to pick out some things that were somewhat rare as well. Next thing I want to play is the Edison advertising record. Now, this particular cylinder was made about 1906 to extol the virtues of the Edison phonograph and was used by dealers. And it is quite rare, though copies are available today. The cylinder is going to be played with a different stylus. I'm going to change this Edison Model C doorknob stylus, and I'm going to use a 2-minute stylus, which is sold by Expert Styly in England, which I find gives a little bit better results, even though it's smaller. You'll find on the bottom of your handout there a key to the different mandrels and styli that we'll be using. This is also a faster cylinder, being later, so we're going to bump that back up to 160 RPM. I'm going to go ahead and play through the entire cylinder on this because it's rather interesting.
I am the Edison phonograph. He did play the great wizard of the new world to delight those who would have melody or beat.
Excuse me. One thing I did not do on this, because I forgot to bring it, was set the level of this machine. And it should be perfectly level. It may be as we go today that we might have a little bit of problem with skipping or repeating of grooves. That can be dealt with by changing the weight on the tone arm, which is relatively easy to do. But the machine should be level, and unfortunately I just can't accomplish that.
I am the Edison phonograph, created by the great wizard of the new world to delight those who would have melody or be amused. I can sing you tender songs of love. I can give you merry tales and joyous laughter. I can transport you to the realms of music. I can call you to join in the rhythmic dance. I can lull the babe to sweet repose, or waken in the aged heart soft memories of youthful days. No matter what may be your mood, I am always ready to entertain you. When your day's work is done, I can bring the theater or the opera to your home. I can give you grand opera, comic opera, or vaudeville. I can give you sacred or popular music, band, orchestra, or instrumental music. I can render solos, duets, trios, quartets. I can aid in entertaining your guests. When your wife is worried after the cares of the day and the children are boisterous, I can rest the one and quiet the other. I never get tired, and you will never tire of me, for I always have something new to offer. I give pleasure to all, young and old. I will go wherever you want me, in the parlor, in the sick room, on the porch, in the camp, or to your summer home. If you sing or talk to me, I will retain your songs or words and repeat them to you at your pleasure. I can enable you to always hear the voices of your loved ones, even though they are far away. I talk in every language. I can help you to learn other languages. I am made with the highest degree of mechanical skill. My voice is the clearest, smoothest, and most natural of any talking machine. The name of my famous master is on my body and tells you that I am a genuine Edison phonograph. The more you become acquainted with me, the better you will like me. Ask the dealer.
Oh, that's great.
Ask the dealer.